The local church onlyists believe each local assembly is individually the bride of Christ, as spot-filled and blemished as it may be. This would of course mean that Christ has multiple brides and is a polygamist, but it also muddles the question of when Christ began his church. Since local churches were all established separately, how can we even know when Christ built his church upon a rock? There are two popularly debated alternatives: the church was founded by Jesus during his earthly ministry, or later at Pentecost. But the Bible actually rejects both notions. Jesus Christ certainly began his work anew during his earthly ministry, but he had been building his church since the beginning of time. That's right. Ephesians 3:21 shows that the church has been around, quote, throughout all ages, world without end. As such, the church, which Hebrews 12 identifies as the heavenly Jerusalem or bride of Christ, consists of all those who put their trust in God from the very beginning. Old Testament saints, New Testament saints, we're all one in Christ, regardless of what the Baptist briders say. Notice in Ephesians 4 how the body, or bride of Christ, spans both testaments. Verse 11 says God gave her apostles, that's New Testament, and God gave her prophets, that's Old Testament. In fact, when the writer of Hebrews tells New Testament saints in chapter 12 they are come to Mount Zion and the church of the firstborn, he's harking back to Psalm 74 in the Old Testament, which calls Mount Zion thy congregation. So Old Testament saints and New Testament saints are in the same congregation. This is not the only reference to the saints in Old Testament Israel as part of the church. In fact, Acts 7:38 even uses the word. Indeed, Hebrews 11, known as the Hall of Faith, lists many Old Testament saints who God made part of his heavenly country, the New Jerusalem. The list includes Abraham, the patriarch of our faith, and even says the city he looked for had multiple foundations, a clear reference to the bride of Christ, the New Jerusalem. So those Old Testament saints are currently part of the same spiritual body or city that one day will be physically inhabited on earth by all who trust the God of Abraham. This is why God called them the church in the wilderness and placed on their Levitical breastplates the same 12 gemstones that make up the 12 foundations of the New Jerusalem. This is why the New Jerusalem is said to have the names of the 12 tribes of Israel in her gates and the names of the 12 apostles in her foundations. The two testaments are one, because they have the same testator, the same Savior, the same groom.